Injury has caused some shuffling on the U.S. women's squad, with the compulsories in the team competition slated for this evening. Out for the competition now is Michelle Campy, who hadn't even competed in the Olympic trials because of a broken elbow. Now she has a hip injury, and she will be replaced by Wendy Bruce. Bruce had finished seventh in the Olympic trials and was an alternate here. Now the six women who will compete in Barcelona are Kim Zemeskal, Shannon Miller, Betty Aquino, Dominique Dawes, Kerry Strug, and Wendy Bruce. One person not on that list is 18-year-old Kim Kelly. John Tesh has her story.
Baltimore, Maryland, June. It is the U.S. Olympic trials and 18-year-old Kim Kelly's last chance to make an Olympic team. Although it was very close, Kelly realized her dream and grabbed what appeared to be the last spot on the squad. She was going to Barcelona, or so she thought. Because of injuries to two gymnasts and a question of who was actually the best for the team, another selection process was held earlier this month in Orlando, Florida. It was a competition closed to the public. No judges, only coaches. It was really another Olympic trials. Finally, following the secret competition, the coaches met into the night, voting, discussing, selecting the Olympic team. The next morning, the U.S. team was announced. But this time, Kim Kelly was not on it.
When it was over, she was very, very happy. She said to me, I had to do it, right? There's no way they can deny me. And when we went to tell her, sorry, kiddo, but you're the one that's out, she thought we were joking. We had to say it four times before she realized that that was the actuality of it. She gave 100%. She couldn't have given any more. And that's all we ask out of her, and we're proud of her.
I just like to say I'm proud of my daughter.
And so while the women's Olympic gymnastics team arrived in Barcelona, Kim Kelly was home, stunned. Her options? Go to the press, file a lawsuit, or just give it all up. Well, Kim decided on her own to jump on a plane and come see the Olympics for herself. Realistically, there is nothing she or her lawyer can do to get her on the squad now, but that doesn't change the fact that Kim Kelly is angry.
I think it's just the whole entire system, maybe the whole USGF, had this planned. I just wish that if they knew that they were going to push me out, they would have done it last year or earlier. I mean, I wasted a whole year. It wasn't a waste, but I took a whole year out of my life to come to make my dream, and I did, and then they took it away from me. And from going from such a high, and then 2 hours later, going to just a shock, you know, it's just really, really hard.
We've changed the process because the United States Olympic Committee has said to us, your mandate is to pick the best team, to field the team that will best represent the United States. And in doing so, we feel that we've got to allow every athlete to be evaluated up to the last moment. It may seem harsh, but that's the reality of what this is.
Well, reality for Kim Kelly right now is getting on with her life. And here in Barcelona, that means life as a spectator.
I think it shows that I'm a strong person to come here, you know, even though I'm supposed to be competing, but that I came anyway.
And there is a look at Kim Kelly joining us now from the gymnastics venue at the Palau Sant Jordi is our gymnastics expert, Elfi Schlegel. Now, Kim Kelly finished sixth at the trials. Wendy Bruce was seventh. But Wendy Bruce selected for the final team ahead of Kim Kelly, and it becomes pertinent because with Michelle Campy now hurt, Bruce moves from alternate to regular team member, and Kelly's still on the outside looking in. Does it strike you as fair, Elfi?
Well, Bob, it's been a very long process, not to mention a very unhealthy one, I believe, for the athletes in getting to these Olympic Games. It's been crazy. You know, they've really been toying with these athletes and their emotions. I feel that the athletes haven't had a really good sense of team unity. They've been questioning right up until yesterday who they were going to be competing with. So I guess I have to side with the athletes at this point. I really don't see it as a fair process. Just because they've been stringing them along for such a great length of time now, and bang, last minute, it's you're not going.
Situation also complicated by the fact that Betty Aquino, who's very highly regarded, was injured at the trials. She petitions onto the team, and probably the best guess is, had she been healthy, and she is healthy enough to compete now, she would have placed at the trial. So that was another subjective judgment, but one that could be defended.
Well, I think you have to defend someone like Betty Aquino. She has proven herself in the past, and I guess when this system was set up, they were really trying to protect those athletes that they felt could win medals at the Olympic Games, and Betty has proven herself over time. And unfortunately, it's such a unique year because of the Olympic Games, and Betty being injured at the U.S. Championships and the Olympic Trials, she didn't have that opportunity to compete. So this system definitely favored Betty Aquino because it protected her right up until this point, and they're looking for great things from Betty here at the Olympic Games.
Okay, Elfi, thanks a lot.